So this song is the last song on No Beginning, No End 2. It's called Oracle. And for those who don't read Japanese characters, it says Mount Takao, which is about an hour south of Tokyo and is one of the holiest mountains in all of Japan. I was lucky enough to make a trip there, and I recorded a lot of the sounds on my iPhone. It was such a beautiful spiritual experience. I knew somehow I wanted to fit that into the album, because a lot of my work deals with spirituality in the same way that, you know, John and Alice Coltrane and Miles Davis introduced within jazz. Sort of non-specific, but uplifting. You know, it's non-religious. And, you know, this is a global endeavor. So we have Eric Trefaz, the legend, on trumpet, Hindi Zara on vocals. And it was a really special, I think, collaboration between all of us.
Yeah, and we actually started, when we started the song, it was you, myself, and Scott Jacoby at his studio, Usonia. You know, and we were kind of looking, as a fan of No Beginning, No End, the original, for me, I wanted to make sure at least some of it had like real like roads, you know? So I kind of sat down with Scott thinking about, as the songwriter, how we could incorporate that without it feeling forced, mm-hmm. because the album had gone in a kind of different, such a different direction sonically. So I put down those Rhodes parts in three, and that's sort of where it started.
We sent that to Hindi as just a instrumental, mm-hmm. and she was like, oh my God, I want to do this. And for me, it, like having her on it is a nice continuum from the first one. Mm-hmm. And I really always want to stress like how global our world is. You know, like we have friends in London, Tokyo, Berlin, you know, Amsterdam, Canada, you know what I mean? But no, really, like our world is a music world, and music is all over the world. So it was really important to get her on it too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To that end, I think this song we were just describing was recorded in 5 studios and mixed in a 6th.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Yeah. France, Belgium, LA, the 20s.
Yeah.
And
the 20s. Usonia, yeah. In New York.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's emblematic of the it sort of speaks to the layers of influence that you're synthesizing, mm. and also the width of the friends around the world, like you're describing as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I feel like on this song, sonically, it builds, it feels worldwide, like it has the most elements and almost harkens back to the work that you two did on While You Were Sleeping.
True.
As a José James fan, mm-hmm. rather than, you know, co-founder of this label and songwriter, that was one of the things I was kind of referencing when we put that choir on at the end, was, you know, Becca Stevens singing on While You Were Sleeping, this like big sweeping end, right. You know.
Can we hear that actually?
Absolutely.
We call it affectionately a Tali choir.
I'm extremely honored. So it kind of builds.
I think this was in total about 16 tracks.
Yeah.
Like 4 sets of 4.
Yeah.
And this also is, as the arrangement is growing and developing, there are large, like, you know, layers continue to increase in density.
Yeah.
It's like ascending to heaven. That's actually, this is exactly what it feels like climbing Mount Takao, just
really
into the clouds. Yeah, mm. absolutely.
And I love how you handled it in the mix too. I was really impressed that there are places, and I clearly don't know that much about mixing, but there are places where you kind of turn down other things and parts of the choir come up, and it just is super special how you mixed it. Oh,
thank you so much.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, I feel like the most important job, and the only job of a good mix, is to serve the creative thrust of the song, mm. to serve the work. And so in that way, the arrangement that you guys gave to me really enabled me to take some risks and build some dynamism in that way by kind of introducing or highlighting different elements in different moments. Mm. And that, you know, I'm always talking about horizontality and like signposts, like markers of the arrangement as they go past. And in that way, the choirs that you build were hugely informative to that, as the density of the arrangement increases.
And I want to shout out the musicians too, because again, they didn't know what we were going to put on top. So all they had to play dynamically and build it towards something. Jamire Williams, Ben Williams, Chris Bowers, really just went in and drove it in this powerful way. So shout out to the musicians, man, once again.
Yeah, it's true. Like in the studio, we were kind of telling them, this will get enormous.
But it's, picture like 100 vocals at the end. Right.
But it's not, you know, and it took a second, but I really, especially Jamire, I feel like he really just gave us so much of his art. Like every single person on this album is a band leader in their own right.
Absolutely.
You know, and so it's a pretty beautiful track.
We didn't even have top line for this, actually.
We didn't, no.
That's right.
We didn't have any lyrics or anything. It was just all basically instrumental, except for Hindi's part.
Yeah, and that was, I mean, to the credit of your incredible songwriting, I kept saying to Jose, maybe we should have top line. Like, do you have it yet? The studio session is tomorrow. The studio session is now. And then everybody did their overdubs, and he still didn't have it. And I've learned over years to just trust you that he said, okay, I'll have it. And then literally on the mic, he wrote that.
Stop it.
Jazz singer of the hip hop generation, man. That's it. You know, bars.
Right.
I'll write a song right now.
On the mic. He wrote it. And I'm sitting there with the engineer and he turned, he said, does he have that? I'm like, I don't know. And I was just like, and he finished. He did it all in one take. I'm so jealous. He finished and he's like, was that good? We're like,
it was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine.
Like, what? Completely finished.
Wow. That's a wonderful nugget that I didn't have access to. Thanks for sharing
my
story.
God.
Yeah,
so shout out to Jose James.
Shout out to Jose James.
Because I had said to him, like, look, I can't, you know, I'm not going to have top line that's yours, you know, like there is something so stylistic about how you sing that even though I've been writing for Jose for 6 years now, I still can't emulate that like very stylistic over the bar line kind of way that you sing. Right. And so, yeah, we just had to wait until the moment of the mic to get it.
Wow, that's pretty special.
I know.
Yeah. And shout out to all my fans in Japan for the inspiration and the culture. Arigato gozaimasu. Killing.
Boom.